it on?
Yeah.
Crosby's gonna have a chance here. It's knocked down by Carlson. Hortquist to the empty net.
It bounced Skip over.
Outside.
And it landed, hit the top of the crease, and bounced over the net. Don't think I've ever seen anything like it. He couldn't do that again in a million years. The whole bench is cracking up. They can't believe it. Kessel's side is hurting right now. He's laughing so much. He's covering his face, Kessel. Kessel can't believe it. He's never laughed so hard.
Jamie Benn passed to Sagan, a 2-on-1 with an empty net. Sagan to Radulov, and they come in offside.
Wow.
Oh, goodness.
That's a free one right there if you're a scorer. That one cuts into your sleep a little bit.
He'll spring it for Sagan. He's got an empty net. If he can settle it down, he does it, and he kicked it up.
No.
And out of play. The empty net's got voodoo tonight.
Oh, my. Oh, he got a mulligan from the offside. Man, he just hooked that thing high.
He needed his forearm. He had his sandwich there.
He couldn't believe it either.
No, he just dropped his stick in disgust. Tyler, settle those hands down. Over-caffeinated with the yawning net.
Ketcher breaks. Zekas in room. Fires amongst the body. Still loose. Can Price dig it out and find it? And he can, as that was a mess.
In the fourth line again, Zekas hitting himself in the head with that stick. He knows what a chance he had.
Bergeron with Marchand.
Marchand scores! Whoa, Nelly!
Marchand, from the faceoff, has cut the deficit to one.
No one's really sure what's going on here. They got their palms in the air. Not sure what went on.
Was there an issue there on Marchand's second goal, Brent?
Yeah, we had four guys in the ice, Dave.
Got it. Thanks. Good luck in the field.
Thank you.
Four guys on the ice. Let's take a look. One, two, three, four. Where is number five? Well, he's not there. And then as Nick Foligno realizes he's supposed to be on the ice, he goes over the boards. The puck hits the ice. The puck goes in the back of the net. So the Blue Jackets, with that goal, have allowed the Bruins to get back in within one.
June 19th of last year, the day that Mike Hoffman was a Shark, traded by Ottawa to San Jose and then on to Florida.
So if there's like a 50-year reunion, is he invited? Like, how does that work?
He's an alum. Yeah, he gets alumni privileges.
And Fleury is now chirping down at David Rittich. Rittich has gone out to the blue line of the flame zone. Fleury is motioning as though he'd take off his gloves. They'd have a fight. Oh, that's funny.
Cooler heads prevail.
What was going on when you set your stick down and he was... Rittich was smacking his stick on the ice at the blue line?
I don't know. I thought he wanted to fight, you know, because he came out and then I went to see and didn't want to. So that was fine. That was it. No big deal.
Would you have?
Yeah, I thought he was coming, but I don't know. It's part of the game. Sometimes things happen, and all that matters is we won the game, you know.
This hits right here. He pushes it off the post. You see off the post as he's pulling from his right to his left. And now this is as the play is going on. If the Dallas player had seen that, he could have just put that shot on net. He didn't realize. And then the training staff couldn't get it on. So he is now in the locker room, and Grubauer is in nets.
Well, Bosch, one of the strangest sequences that I've seen
in the last decade in the NHL. And look out, the glass came popping out.
I don't think you guys can go home with that souvenir.
The poise of some of the fans in the front row didn't want to spill their beverages.
There's a moment of fame for those fans.
Exactly.
Glad no one's hurt.
That's a heavy piece of glass, and they're enjoying themselves.
Here's the goaltender, Mackenzie Blackwood. So a good night goes to bad.
Yeah.
Well, it's funny to us, not to him.
As Homer Simpson once said, it's funny because it's not happening to me.
Right.
The Rangers will be shorthanded. You're right on the call, Joe. Shattenkirk for hooking at 220.
Silverberg steals it center and scores. He got the water bottle high, short side on Grubauer, and the Ducks get the game's first goal.
He blew up the water bottle. Top went flying. All the water comes flying out.
Up top for Truba. Back for Wheeler. And Shifley's stick goes way in the air.
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
I think it was Char, right? Didn't he knock Shifley's stick about 40 feet into the air?
Comes down in behind the Boston net and
Shifley looking over at the referee,
saying, how can that not be interference? His stick ended up off the netting behind Rask.
This kid is a wheeler dealer.
EJ, I'll trade my sister for a stick. So EJ does the nice thing, signs a stick, gives it to him. But look what showed up tonight. This is phenomenal. EJ, trades a trade. Here's my sister. That is just fantastic.
And a shot down the ice by Tampa Bay. Sparks can't go out after it because it's in the non-trapezoidal area, and there's a man coming to the front of the net. Pass in front, they score!
This is embarrassing.
3-0.
As the Leafs are on a change, and a horrible change.
Look at the top of your screen. Look at Toronto. I don't know what they thought, but Lightning have three guys, three against one. Everybody else is making a line change for Toronto.
I don't know if I've seen a play quite like that in some time. That's a brain cramp in the biggest way. Bolin for Montreal sends it in. Oh, good reaction, but they score on the rebound. Armia gets the goal. A bad carom. Lundqvist was able to stop it, but Armia there to put in the rebound.
Innocent looking wraparound, right? Now bounces right to the crease. Lundqvist can't control the puck.
As Larson's errant pass is picked up by Price, nearly gave it to Terry, who did get it. And Henrik scores.
And that is this game in a nutshell.
Now this is a bad mistake by Carey Price. Boy, and Price even stumbled as he got back to his own net. Boy, it's a comedy of errors.
Gostis for the blast. They score! Redirected in front.
It was a strange play off the shin pad of Couturier and off of Lindblom after that.
Backhands for Barry with the shot off his feet, oh! And it rebounds and they score.
Off Travis Ajak. Poor Travis. Oh, it's unbelievable. Severson gets it with his foot.
Yep.
And he's deflecting it across. Oh, my. Double deflection, double trouble.
You can't make those ones up.
Carried back the other way. Here's Pearson over the line. Shooting. He scores. Oh, the miscue by Blackwood.
It was going wide. Blackwood tried to get it toward the corner. Deflected off his stick it in.
You can't let these in, and I feel bad. McKenzie's going to just beat himself up.
Coyote squad that we know and love.
Shot the goal! A misplay, and the Coyotes capitalize. Go figure.
Well, there it is. Hockey is a game of mistakes.
Hedman working it on through. Holpe there trying to bypass the forecheck of Cirelli. Holpe has to get back, and this one caroms in. Kolarov and Dmitry Orlov pass to surprise Braden Holtby.
He tries to help his goaltender out, and that's no help. Dubnyk lets him go fast. And Zibanejad scores! He fired from the corner with Dubnyk moving and put it in.
If Dubnyk doesn't touch this, it just skirts through the crease. But I think it catches the inside of his stick, and it goes into his own net.
Here's Stahl 2-on-1 with Parisi. Stahl! That way, and he scores!
And watch the stick. He sweeps it around, and he actually bats it in on his own goaltender.
And he looks at the big board and sees it and says, oh, boy.
Well, these pregame interviews for my partner can be downright hazardous. My goodness, you deserve combat pay for that. What happened, partner?
That's my dear friend Jordan Martinuk, and he gave me an avalanche snow shower.
There's Johnny Gaudreau. They're just sitting between both goal scorers and giving them some love. And look at the smiles.
He looked like Oprah. You get a goal, and you get a goal.
Now that I've done that, I'm going to have to do it again. You know that.
Yeah, I'm not a superstitious guy. I'm a little stitious, but I guess you're going to have to do that again.
I'm not superstitious, but I am a little stitious.
What are you looking forward to as you step on the ice for your first game?
How are you, sir? Ever dreamed of wearing this jersey, but I'm pretty excited. I'm getting a little water for my teammate here. I'll try to block you out of it.
Thanks so much for your time. We appreciate it.
Thanks,
sir. Oh, Ryan, wait. Hey!
Of course, St. Patty's Day festivities going on all over Boston. And now look who's taking center stage. UFC legend Conor McGregor. He's got everybody here on their feet. He's trying to get the crowd going, not to mention the Bruins. I'd say the boys on the bench will be fired up at this one.
Bergeron recovers the puck. Bergeron to Marchand. He scores! Brad Marchand! The Bruins put an emphatic end to their three-game losing streak. Brad Marchand with his 15th career overtime goal.
What a combination those two players are.
I'm not sure I like this call.
We got a call? Interference?
That's got to be on Thomas Tatar.
Jarvis! In there. It's interference. No.
We got a sense of Mark Joinette talking to Thomas Tatar. He's got to get in there. It's interference.
The referees are going to try and take the temperature down a little bit, but Seti's temperature is still up, and he's done. He might get an extra. Yeah, he just got two more for that.
13 has two for Slashy. Two for Exports Play Conduct.
Across to Pullock. He fell down. His stick got caught in between two panes of glass.
You don't see this very often. It's heading up the ice. Stick just gets caught. One of those things you just don't expect it. Like, what just happened?
Back the other way for CC Tipovos. Bunches in and out. Scores!
And that's six more goals against the Leafs. And for Kyle Dubas, a lot of head scratching.
Zach Smith off the stick of Krug. And a fine grab in row number six.
That's paying attention.
Didn't even spill a drop.
It was cut off by Dickinson. Couldn't keep the puck in. And then Ben collided with his teammate Lesperance, and it broke his stick.
In three. You don't see that very often.
Scott Hartnell and young Wesley Hartnell dropping the puck, and it was a pretty hard-fought faceoff.
I don't know if that's ever been done before. Justin Williams was ready for that one, too. Those won it. He legit won it. They were going at it.
Snaps the pass across right on the door. Steph Barry. 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 Devon Shore.
Carl Hagelin getting familiar with his get over.
Be me getting whacked. I know it's coming. I can feel it. Boom. Who was that that high stuck me? Jones.
A little bit of blood, I think.
Look at you. Wow.
That's what happens when you go to the dirty areas, man. I thought I was done with this part of the game. This is the part I don't miss.
Been so consistent this year. Perhaps his most consistent year.
Look out. Odd Karam off the referee. Had to be kept out by Luongo. Tipped on goal.
That puck did not go around the boards like it's normally supposed to. Roberto is ready.